Shepherds after my own heart, who will shepherd you wisely and prudently? Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Lord our God, who governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will to these deacons of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood. so that by their ministry and life, they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me thus: Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me, Say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, See, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, as in one body we have many parts, and all the parts do not have the same function. So we, though many, are one body in Christ, and individually parts of one another. Since we have gifts that differ to the grace given to us, let us exercise them. If prophecy, in proportion to the faith. If ministry, in ministering. If one is a teacher, in teaching. If one exhorts, in exhortation. If one contributes, in generosity. If one is over others, with diligence. If one does acts of mercy, with cheerfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Let those who are to be ordained priests come forward. Jeffrey Joseph Church. Present. Dylan Stewart Crawley. Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those concerned with their formation, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and of our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose these our brothers for the order of the priesthood. Thanks be to God. A few months ago, Pope Francis held an audience at the Vatican with the community of the North American College, the U.S. Seminary in Rome. Being an alumnus of the North American College, I read the Pope's speech with great interest. Also, being a fan of Pope Francis and his pastoral sense, in spite of what he did to me back in the fall of 2016, but on a day like this, all is forgiven. I resonated with the Holy Father's message. And so I invite us to consider the three points he made in that audience regarding formation for priesthood. Realize that we priests, like all the lay faithful, but we priests are continually in formation for our priesthood, as are you continually in formation for living the Christian life. And the bishops of the United States will be considering at our June assembly in about 10 days the proposed U.S. plan for the ongoing formation of priests. It is that important. The Holy Father advances three themes: dialogue, communion, and mission. Let's consider those three themes in light of our festive gathering here this morning, along with the ritual's prepared text for the ordination to the order of presbyter. We begin with dialogue. Jeff and Dylan, I'd like Pope Francis to speak to you for a moment. The Lord enters into a personal dialogue with you, asking what you are looking for and inviting you to come and see, to speak with him from your hearts and give yourselves to him confidently in faith and love. Doing so involves fostering a daily relationship with Jesus, one nourished especially by prayer, meditation on the Word of God, the help of spiritual accompaniment, and listening to him in silence before the tabernacle. For it is in these moments of familiar relationship with the Lord that we can best hear his voice and discover how to serve him and his people generously and wholeheartedly. The Lord is calling you into that dialogue. He called the prophet Jeremiah, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you." Now, Jeff, you might not be able to respond as did Jeremiah, but I think Dylan can. "Ah, Lord God, I know not how to speak. I'm too young." But the Lord says to you both, "To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. See, I place my words in your mouth." The rite of ordination reminds us, our great high priest, Jesus Christ, chose certain of his disciples to exercise in his name on behalf of the human race a public priestly office in the church. For Christ, who was sent from the Father, himself in turn sent the apostles into the world, that through them and their successors, the bishops, he might exercise without ceasing his own office of teacher, priest, and shepherd. Dialogue with the Lord and your people. Communion. Attachment. Meaningful relationship. Intimate involvement with life's ups and downs. Pope Francis reminds you, Jeff and Dylan, and all of us priests, by staying with Jesus, the disciples began to learn from his words, gestures, and even his gaze what really mattered to him and what his Father had sent him to proclaim. I invite you to keep your eyes open both to the mystery of the church's unity, manifested in legitimate diversity, yet lived in the oneness of faith, and to the prophetic witness of charity that the church expresses through her concrete acts of care for those in need. It is my hope that these experiences will help you develop that fraternal love capable of seeing the grandeur of our neighbor, of finding God in every human being, of tolerating the nuisances of life in common. Nuisances of life? Never in priesthood. Never in parish life. Actually, the nuisances of life are all around us. But they must not be allowed to steal from us our shepherd's heart. A heart that consistently manifests pastoral care and solicitude. Jeff, I suspect your care and solicitude will shine through via your humor and wit. Dylan, your capacity for care and solicitude has helped to restore into our midst the last priest I was privileged to ordain, as Father Seth is happily in our midst today. Thank you for that. Jesus has modeled such and described it for us. I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. I know mine and mine know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. There will be one flock, one shepherd. The rite of ordination speaks profoundly of this theme as lived out in presbyteral ministry, addressing us, the assembly, and then those to be ordained. These, our brothers, are to be ordained to the priesthood in the order of the presbyterate, that they may serve Christ, the teacher, priest, and shepherd. By the priestly ministry, his body, the church, is built up and grows into a holy temple, the people of God. These men are to be configured to Christ, the eternal high priest, and joined to the priesthood of the bishops. They will be consecrated as true priests of the New Testament in order to preach the gospel, shepherd God's people, and celebrate divine worship, especially the Lord's sacrifice. Dear sons, united with your bishop and subject to him, fulfill the office of Christ, head and shepherd, to the best of your ability. Strive to gather the faithful together into one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father through Christ and in the Holy Spirit. Keep always before your eyes the example of the good shepherd, who did not come to be served, but to serve, and who came to seek and to save what was lost. And finally, the Holy Father emphasizes mission. Mission lived out through the exercise of a variety of gifts. St. Paul enumerated some of the gifts for us: prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, generosity, diligence, mercy, and cheerfulness. Each of us, with our respective knowledge of these two men, can apply those gifts to each of them. Pope Francis speaks of the mission of priesthood, saying, "Here we see how witness, born of dialogue and communion with Christ, becomes mission. The newly called disciples go on to attract others by their testimony." Whenever Jesus calls men and women, he always does so in order to send them out, in particular to the vulnerable and those on the margins of society, whom we are not only called to serve, but from whom we can also learn much. People nowadays need us to listen to their questions, anxieties, and dreams so that we can better lead them to the Lord, who rekindles hope and renews the life of all. Through ordination, we are set apart for that mission, consecrated. The rite of ordination speaks of and to you, Jeff and Dylan, and to all of us, brothers in the priesthood. Meditating on the law of the Lord, see that you believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Let your teaching be nourishment for the people of God, and let the holiness of your life be a pleasing fragrance for Christ faithful, so that you may build up by word and example that house which is the church of God. You will also exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying, for by your ministry the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful will be made perfect. In the celebration of the mysteries, it is united to the sacrifice of Christ, which is offered through your hands in union with them in an unbloody manner on the altar. Understand, therefore, what you do, and imitate what you celebrate. As celebrants of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, may you strive to put to death whatever is sinful within you and to walk in newness of life. Remember, when you gather men and women into the people of God through baptism, and in the name of Christ and the church forgive sins in the sacrament of penance, when you comfort the sick with holy oil and celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer praise and thanksgiving through the hours of the day and pray not only for the people of God but for the whole world, always remember that you have been taken from among the people and appointed on their behalf in those things that pertain to God. Fulfill, therefore, the ministry of Christ the priest with abiding joy and genuine love. Seek not your own concerns, but those of Jesus Christ. The concerns of Jesus Christ, the Good Shepherd. In a few moments, you will be ordained priests forever. As your lives are transformed more into his image, as you take on by God's grace the person of Christ, hear now and always his message whispered into your ears and sung from our hearts. If you love me, feed my lambs. Be my heart, my voice, my hands. If you love me, feed my sheep. And for my part, I give you a heart of a shepherd. The heart of a shepherd. My prayer for all our priests. My prayer for myself. The heart of a shepherd. If you love me, feed my lambs. Be my heart, my voice, my hands. If you love me, feed my sheep. for my part. I give you the heart of a shepherd. Dear sons, before you proceed to the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your resolve to undertake this office. Do you resolve to discharge unfailingly, with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the office of the priesthood in the presbyteral rank as trustworthy co-workers with the order of bishops in feeding the Lord's flock? Do you resolve to carry out the ministry of the word worthily and wisely in the preaching of the gospel and the teaching of the Catholic faith?
Do
you resolve to celebrate the mysteries of Christ reverently and faithfully according to the tradition of the church, especially in the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation for the praise of God and the sanctification of the Christian people? Do you resolve to implore with us the mercy of God for the people entrusted to you with zeal for the commandment to pray without ceasing? And do you resolve to be united more closely each day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all? Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Let us pray, dearly beloved, to God the Almighty Father, that he pour forth heavenly gifts in abundance on these his servants, whom he has chosen for the office of the priesthood. Let us kneel.
Let us kneel.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
perpetua and saints felicity.
Pray for us.
Saint Agnes.
Pray for us.
Saint Gregory.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine.
Pray for us.
Saint Athanasius. Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
Saints of God,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your incarnation.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your death and resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord,
merciful to us sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Guide and protect your holy church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all the clergy in faithful service to your church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Peoples together in trust and peace.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Strengthen us in your service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen ones.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen ones and make them.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen ones, make them holy, and consecrate them for their sacred duties.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ,
hear us, we pray, O Lord our God, and pour out upon these your servants the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that you may surround with your rich and unfailing gifts those whom we present to your fatherly care for consecration. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us stand.
Draw near, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, author of human dignity and bestower of all graces, through whom all things progress, through whom everything is made firm, who by the power of the Holy Spirit, in order to form a priestly people, establish among them ministers of Christ your Son in various orders. Already in the earlier covenant, there arose offices instituted by mystical rites, so that when you had set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in order and dignity to join them and assist them in their work. Thus, in the desert, you instilled the spirit of Moses in the minds of 70 wise men. With them as helpers, he more easily governed your people. So too, over the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's fullness, that the number of priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, the apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself unblemished to you and made his apostles who were consecrated in the truth sharers in his mission. To them you added companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation through all the world. Now we pray, O Lord, provide also for our weakness these helpers whom we need for the exercise of the apostolic priesthood. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they hold the office second in order, received from you, O God. And by the example of their manner of life, may they inspire right conduct. May they be trustworthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed through the cleansing waters of rebirth and refreshed from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined to us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to them and for the whole world. Thus may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ become your one people brought to perfection in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
May the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. May the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you will do. Imitate what you will celebrate. And conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you will do, imitate what you will celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who willed that your priest should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with the brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and for all who dare, who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protection and help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for these your servants, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood. And in your mercy, keep safe your gifts in them, so that what they have received by divine commission, they may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty,
in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
one cup of blessing which we bless, and we the many throughout the earth. We are one body in this one Lord.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood.
Amen.
May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth, and faithful ministers of reconciliation.
Amen.
And may he make you true shepherds to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.